हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर सुभाष साहू, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द्रव्यगुण। टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द प्लांट गुगुल। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द रक्त प्रसादन द्रव्य। टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द वेदनास्थापन द्रव्य। वेदनास्थापन द्रव्य मीन्स एनाल्जेसिक ड्रग व्हिच रिड्यूस द वेदना और पेन, which subside the drugs which are used to subside or cure the pain is known as vedanasthapan drug. In this group there are so many important drugs like gugulu, rasna, eranda, nirgundi, rasona, devdaru, kadamba, suchi and many more, but these are the important plants which is used for vedanasthapan drugya. The first one is gugul. Gugul. The word gugul is derived from the French word gudati rakshati vata rogana iti gugulu, which means the drug which has the potential to prevent the person from vata roga is known as gugul. Mythologically, it is believed that the gugul is derived as nectar or evolved as nectar during the Deva Asura Sangram by Lord Vishnu to replace or to recover the lost strength, Surya and Tejas of Devata. It is mentioned in the Ashtanga Sangraha. Gugul is a wide range of uses in traditional medicines and it is considered as one of the best analgesic and anti-inflammatory drugs in Ayurveda. So it has many uses found in Ayurvedic classics. The vernacular names of this plant is gugulu, gugula, gugal, gurar, then gugul dhop, kanthagan, gugulu, etc. All these names are represented in the slide. Then various important synonyms of gugul: devadhupa. Deva dhupa means deva, matlab god. Dhupa matlab dhupa or incense. The incense prepared from the resin of this plant is used for the worshiping of the god. Then kana niryasa. Kana means crystals or particles. Niryasa means exuded. The exuded is crystalline in nature, so it is known as kana niryasa. Kosika. Kosika means the gum resin is produced from the cells of this plant. So it is known as kosika. Then kumbha ulukhala. The exudate is produced inside the cavity of the plant. So it is known as kumbha ulukhala. Then mahisaksha. Mahisa means buffalo. Aksha matlab eye. The color of the gum resin is similar to the color of eye of a buffalo. So it is known as mahisaksha. Then maru desha. Maru means desert place. Desha matlab area. This plant naturally grow in the sandy arid region. So it is known as maru desha. Then palang kasa. Palang means fat. Kasa matlab karsan, reducing. So this exudate is used to scrape away the excessive fat, or it reduce the fat from the body. So it is known as palang kasa. Then pura. Pura means exudate. The exudate is highly potent, so it is known as pura. The rakshoha. Rakshoha means antiseptic. The resin is used as an antiseptic and also it is used for fumigation. So it is known as rakshoha. Ulukhala. Ulukhala, as I have told earlier, the exudate is produced and collected inside the cavity of the tree. So it is known as ulukhala. The Latin name of this plant is Commiphora mucul. It is belong to Vaccinaceae family. Then classical categorizations. In Charaka Samhita, it is mentioned in Sangyasthapan Mahakasaya. According to Susruta, it comes under Aladi Gan. Ashtahruda also mentioned it in Aladi Gan. Dhanvantari Nigantu mentioned in Chandanadi Varga. Madanphal Nigantu in Karpuradi Varga. Kaidev Nigantu in Aushadi Varga. Raj Nigantu in Chandanadi Varga. And Mahaprakash Nigantu in Karpuradi Varga. The distribution. The plant gugul is a native plant of northern Africa and central Asia. In India, it is mostly found in the arid rocky places of Rajasthan, Gujarat, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, and Karnataka. Then morphology of this plant. It is a small tree or it is a shrub with spinous branches. It nearly reach up to the height up to a height of 7 to 8 feet. The young branches are aromatic and brownish red in color. This plant is found in three form, on its male, on its female, and bisexual plants are also available. Then bark. The bark is characterized by the presence of silvery paper-like brownish bark, which peels off regularly. Below the silvery bark, the stem is green in color. Then leaves. Leaves are trifoliate, alternate, and the terminal leaflet is biggest in comparison to the lateral leaflet. The lateral leaflets are half in size. It is alternate, rhomboid, ovate shape, serrated margin, minutely serrated margin, and the petiole is reddish brown in color. The dorsal and ventral side of this leaf is shown in the slide. Then flowers. Flowers are very small, brownish red in color. The fascicles of 2 and 3 are found. Pedicels are very small. Calyx is glandular, hairy, and campanulate. Petals are brownish red in color, broadly linear. Stamens are 8 to 10 in number, alternately long and short. Ovary is oblong and ovate, attenuated into the style. The red color image is the flower of gugul. Then fruits. Fruits are also very small, oval-shaped drupes. It becomes red when it ripe, and it easily split into two parts. The flowering season is March to April, and the fruiting season is May to June. Then exudate. Exudate is mainly obtained from the duct of in the bark. It is oligum resin. When it is fresh, the resin is pale yellow or white yellowish color. Then aromatic. After collection, it is opaque, aromatic, reddish brown, and dusty surface. Mixed with sand, consists of irregular round masses of various size. The best quality of resin is thick, aromatic. It burn completely in fire. It also melt easily in the sunlight, and it turns milky white when it dissolves in water. The white color milky exudate is the oligum resin of gugul. Then types. Mahaprakash and Kavitar Nighantu has described 5 types of gugul. One is Mahishaksha, the second one is Mahanila, then Kumuda, Padma, and Hiranyaksha. Mahishaksha is honeybee or anjan or black in color. Mahanila is blue in color. Kumuda is Kumuda Puspa color or white in color. Padma is Manikya or ruby color. And Hiranyaksha is Hiranya or Hema color or gold color. Mahishaksha and Mahanila is used for elephants. Then Kumuda and Padma variety is used for horses. Then Hiranyaksha variety is used in human beings. There are also 2 types of commercial variety of gugul is available in the Indian market. One is Bhaisa gugul and the second one is Kana gugul. Bhaisa gugul is compared to Mahishaksha variety, while Kana gugul is compared to Hiranyaksha variety. Bhaisa gugul is dark green to yellow in color, and it is mainly found in the market of Gujarat. Reddish yellow color is the Kana gugul, and it is mainly found in Rajasthan. Then Raspanchak. There are 2 types of gugul as per the procurement. One is fresh gugul and the second one is old gugul or Purana gugul. Purana gugul is laghu, ruksha, tikshna, sukshma, visad, and sara in properties or guna. While fresh gugul is snigdha and pichil. The rasa of gugul is तिक्त कटु एंड कषाय, इट हैज कटु विपाक एंड उष्ण वीर्य. देन केमिकल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट, गूगल कंटेंट वोलाटाइल ऑयल रेसिन गम एंड बिटर कंपाउंड्स. द ओलियोगम रेसिन कंटेन द गुगलोस्टेरल्स जेड एंड ई, गुगलोस्टेरल्स 1, 2 and 3. देन कोलेस्टेरल, म्यूकोलल आर कैम्फोरिन, देन सिम्ब्रिन एक्सेट्रा. द अदर कंपाउंड्स आर मिर्सिन, पॉलीमिर्सिन, शुगर, कैरियोफाइलिन, फ्लेवोनॉइड्स लाइक क्वेरसेटिन. Then action. The main action of Google is Sangyasthapan, Vedanasthapan, Rasayan, Bhagna Sandhanakar, or it helps to for bone union. Then Swarya, Krimikna, Sotahar, Riddhya, Gandavala Nasak, Deepan, Sita Prasaman, Vrana Sodhan and Vrana Ropan, Nadi Valyakar, Yakrit Uttejak, Rakta Prasadan, and Bhutagna, Medhya, and Asmari Vedan and Mutran. The action of Res Google and old Google is quite different. For different purpose, different type of Googles are used. Res Google is Snigdha, Pichil, Kanchana Sankas, or it looks like Pakpa Jambu Phal, or it looks like the ripened Jambu fruit. It is aromatic or Sugandhi. And it is Balya, Brahmanya, Rasayan, Brisya, Arthavajanan, and Uttajak action. While old Google is Shuska, Durgandhi, it has bad odor. It has Lekhan properties, Medhahar properties, Sukranasan properties, and it has devoid of natural color and potency. Then action on Dosa, Dhatu, and Mala. Google is Tridosa Samak. It has Rasayan properties. And it has anuloman and mutral action. Then pharmacological action, it has reported that it has anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer, antimicrobial, hypolipidemic, anti-diabetic, anti-arthritic, anthelmintic, antioxidant, neuroprotective, liver stimulant, antispasmodic, and diuretic properties. Then indication, it has a lot of indication described in the Ayurvedic classics. Mainly it is mentioned in the different types of Vata Vyadhi and joints disorders to reduce the pain. It is mainly used in Vata Vyadhi, Gidrasi or Sciatica, then Ardit Vata or facial paralysis, then Pakshaghat or hemiplegia, then Nadi Sula or neuralgic pain, then arthritis, then Sandhi Vata, Vata Rakta or gout, then Medha Roga or obesity, then Prameha or diabetes, so for swelling, Gandamala, Scrofula, Kushta skin diseases, Sweta Kushta Lycoderma, then worm infestations, then hemorrhoids, then Granthi, Agnimandya, Hridroga, Pandu, Glaipya, then renal calculus, then Kshaya, then Bhutasvika. It is also used in Kasa, Swasa, Slipada and Vrana. Then contraindication and precaution to be taken during the administration of Google. During the administration of Google, one should avoid the intake of amladrabhya, tikshnadrabhya, and ajirna bhojan, vyavaya, srama, hath of seven, madhyan, rosa. This should be prevented during the indication of or administration of Google. Then therapeutic uses. First one is Vrana or wounds. Decoction of Google and Trifala is used for washing of wounds, then Kushta, Nadi and Vagandhar. Then it is used in Amavata or arthritis. Decoction prepared with Google, Guruchi, Sunti and Gokshur is given in the dose of 50 ml twice daily in rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis, joint pain, stiffness of joint, muscular pain and backache. Then Vata Rakta or gout. Regular use of Silajatu, Gugul and Madhu is beneficial in Vata Rakta. Then all types of Vata Vyadhi. Using of Silajatu and Gugul with milk alleviates Vata Vyadhi. Then Gidrasi or Sciatica. Tablet prepared of Rasna and Gugul with ghee is used in Gidrasi. Then Stolya or obesity. Regular use of use of rasanjan, vratpanchamul, gugul, silajatu and agnimantha is beneficial in obesity. Then official parts use and dose. The official part use is oligum resin or nirias, and it is given in the dose of 2 to 4 gram. All types of gugul preparation found in Ayurveda is prepared from gugul only. There is no other substitute. Mainly Yograj gugul, Kaisar gugul, Trifala gugul, Gakshuradi gugul, Trayodashanga gugul, Lakshadi gugul, Vyosadi gugul, Vatari gugul, Singhanada gugul, Kanchanar gugul, Saptavinshati gugul, Punannavadi gugul, and Chandrabhavati. These are the important formulation of gugul. Then toxicity or adverse effect. If gugul is taken in inappropriate doses, it can causes liver and lung. It can causes the liver and lung damage. If it is given in overdoses, it may causes vertigo, dryness in mouth, impotency, debilitating, and muscle wasting. As per another study, it is reported that long-term and higher doses administration of gugul may lead to side effects like timira or cataract, mukha shosha, dryness of mouth, colloidal impotency, then karcha, emaciation, then moha, then samal sithala bhava or diarrhea, then deha rukshata or dryness of body. Then substitution and adulteration. The other type of oleogum resins are used as an adulterant of gugul, mainly Boswellia serrata. Salaki nirias is used as the most popular adulterant of gugul. The other are Camiphora myra or Camiphora roxburghii, then Sterculia urens, then Buttia monosperma or Pallas nirias, then Acacia nilotica, then Moringa oleifera or Sahidan sigru nirias, and Acacia catechu or bubble nirias are mainly used as adulterant of gugul. Then purification, as gugul is though gugul is not a poisonous substance, still it is mixture or adulterate with other foreign articles during its collection, so it needs purification for better result. Traditionally, gugul is purified by boiling in Trifala Quath for 3 hours in Dola Yantra, then it is fried with ghee. Then according to Vaishya Ratnavali, decoction of guruchi, Trifala and cow milk is also used for its purification. This is the shloka of Mahaprakash Nigrantha regarding gugul. Here the synonyms, types of gugul and properties of gugul is mentioned in detail in Mahaprakash Nigrantha. Thank you.